Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this video I am going to show you some code for SwiftyPlistManager. We are going to get, save and fetch some values from our plist files. So without further ado, let's dive in. First of all, SwiftyPlistManager needs a default starting plist file. So, if you haven't already downloaded the master SwiftyPlistManager, then go ahead and do so. And inside of it, you will find a data.plist file and an other data.plist file. So, we will just move all of them, both of them, into our project. Okay. Let's just click on finish. And now we have our data.plist file and our other data. We will leave the other data plist file as is, as an empty, because this will be only for an example, and we will use our data.plist file. For now, this is an empty plist file, so let's add a new value to it. So I will just click on this little plus button and add our, let's say, new key. And for the value, it will be a string. And I will say, hello, SwiftyPlistManager. Great. And here we are. We have a data.plist file with one key value pair. Great. Now let's go back to view controller, and we should start SwiftyPlistManager. But before we do that, I will let you on a little secret, and that is to be typo safe. And we will do that with the help of some constants. And those constants that I will use in this tutorial are found again in our downloaded folder inside the view controller file. So go ahead and double click on it to open it and just scroll down. And here you can see that we have a lot of constants and one variable. Okay, let's just copy these out and add them to our viewDidLoad function. Xcode will complain and there will be a lot of warnings. Here they are, but once we will use all of these value constants, these warnings will go away. Okay, now the first constant is data plist name, and that is the data. And as you can see, we have an other data plist name and other data. Great. And what we should be aware of at the moment is that we have a new key constant with the new key value. Okay. Now, back to SwiftyPlistManager. In order for SwiftyPlistManager to work, we need to start, and we need to start it only once, but we need to start with a plist file, at least a plist file. So let's do that. SwiftyPlistManager.shared and find start. And as you can see, we have a plist names, an array of strings, and logging. It should be a bool value, true or false. And logging, if it is true, we will see a lot of logs in our console. If it is false, we will see nothing. And of course, if you haven't already done so, we need to import SwiftyPlistManager. Okay, let's hit return. And now I will just enter, of course this will be an array, but I will just enter the data. Okay, and that is the data plist name. And see how constants come in handy now. And for the logging, it should be true, of course, because we need to see what happens behind the scenes. Okay, let's just build and run and test it out on a simulator. Of course, the simulator doesn't matter what it says. It will be a blank screen, but we should have a successful build and some logs in the console. And here we are, starting SwiftyPlistManager, initialize data.plist, and initialization complete. Great. Good stuff here. And now I will just add another plist name, and that is other data plist name. And let's just build and run that too, so you may see that we can get an array of plists. That is correct. Initialized other data.plist. Okay, fun stuff here. Now we have started our plist file, the Swifty plist manager with plist files. And we just delete this for now, because we are going to use only the data plist name. And now we want to get the value from our data plist file, and the value that is with for the key, new key. So let's do that. Type in SwiftyPlistManager shared. And here we have a bunch of options, but I will use for now get value, and for what is the key name, and the key name is new key, of course, and from plist with name. Now, and that is the data plist name. You could also use the other plist name if you have started it, but for now we will use the data plist name. And here we have a nice completion, hit return, and we will have a result. And let me just go back there. As you can see, we have an optional result, and we will dive in later how to cast that out. We have a result here, and we have a SwiftyPlistManager error that is also an optional. So I will type in error. And let's go to the code. And first of all, we need to check if there was an error fetching our new value. So getting our new value, because in a moment you will see the differences between getting and fetching. Okay, so if error equals nil, so we don't have any errors, then we can, let's just say, print it out. Print, and let's say the value for key, and this is the key, new key, is, and here we have our result. So let's just add our result here, from the plist, and I will just type in data plist name. Okay, let's just see what happens. And instantly we have a warning, because the result is an optional. So let's just use the simple bang operator here for now, and let's see what happens. Okay, build succeeded, great. And here we have the value for key, new key, is hello SPM from the plist data. Of course, that is the name of the plist. I will just plist, and I will just add on plist here for the sake of being real nice here. Okay. Banging these optional results out is pretty dangerous. So one way to deal with this is, let's say, to add the default value. So I would just type in here no value. And if we wouldn't have any value, then this no value would be printed out. But since this is not the case, this will not happen. Another way, a good way, and the best way, of course, is to use guard let statements. So let me just go up here and let's just cast it out with a guard let statement. Guard let result equals result. Okay, else we will return. Okay, now we have casted out our result, and we no longer need to worry about being it an optional. So we can delete that, and let's just build and run again. And of course, we will see nothing different in the console, The value for key new key is hello SPM from the plist data.plist. Okay, but we are much, well, 100% safe. Another way to do that, if you don't want to instantly return if there is no result, is to use the if-let statement. So I just delete this and I will if-let result equals result. Then we will print out this into the log. I will just copy this out and paste it here. The advantage using if-let statement over the guard-let is that when using the if-let statement, you can still continue down the line of code. So I will just print out here. Okay, let's just build and run and see what happens. If this print statement would have been set after the guard-let statement and the guard-let statement failed, then this hello I'm still printed out here wouldn't have been printed out. But for the if-let statement, it would be, even if the result was nil. Okay, now that we have all that set up, let me just delete this and leave the if-let statement because that's fine with me. Let's just save another value for our key. Okay, and that is pretty easy. Inside the view did load statement, please. SwiftyPlistManager shared and find the save value and for the key to the plist with name, and we also have a completion. So I would just hit return on that. And now let's save. It can be say anything, but I will just save this. Let's just see, hello new value. Just copy this out and paste it in. And for the key, that is the new key, because we want to change the current value, and to plist with name, and that is the data plist name, and we have here a completion. And of course we need to check for errors, so here is our error, and just type it in, if error equals nil, then we may continue. And we should let's say print out hello new value for key and that is to plist. Oh, we don't have access to that. Now let's just say hello new word. Okay. We will check if the save was actually made later on. So let's just build and run this. And value, if I try a bit, let's build and run again. And let's see if that went okay. Okay, here it is. An action has been performed, and here is saved successfully value, new value, and we have a lot more inside SwiftyPlistManager's log. An action has been performed. You can check if it went okay by taking a look at the current content of the data plist file. And here we have new key and hello new value. Now, this is printed out and it is saved. I promise we will maybe take a look at it later and get the value and print it out. But if you take a look at the data.plist file, you see that nothing has changed. And that is the way it should be, because changes are made with inside the data, the document directory of our Xcode project. So let's go back here, and let's just I will leave fetching values for the next video. Okay, hope you liked this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, that other button seems to work okay as well. And if you want to see more of these kind of videos, you could just simply hit the subscribe button down below, and I will see you in the next one.